Welcome sa programming language with compiler. We are now at the pre-final second part. So dito tayo sa second part. Ito second part, runtime environments part 1. Okay. So after this you can take the pre-final quiz 2. Okay? So let's go now to the topic. Okay. So what is runtime environment? First, a program is a source code, no? And a source code is merely a collection of text, code, or statements. And to make it alive, it requires actions to be performed on the target machine, no? Runtime support system is a package mostly generated with the executable program itself and facilitates the process communication between the process and the runtime environment. So, yung source code, yung program natin, tumatakbo siya sa isang tinatawag nating runtime environment, no? And sa loob ng runtime environment, nandun yung runtime support system. And this is the package, no? Generated with the executable program itself, no? Facilitates, like yung ating UI, yung user interface natin na Eclipse, no? So meron siyang runtime environment para sa Java, Java ng mga source code na tinatype natin sa kanya, no? So yun yung package, no? Nandun yung mga libraries ng Java para tumakbo ng maayos yung ating program, okay? So, ang process na sinasabi dito is ito mismo yung program na tumatakbo. Okay? When by runtime we mean a program in execution, no? Runtime environment is a state of the target machine which may include software libraries, environment variables, etc., no? So, kapag niran natin yung ating code, no, in-execute natin, yung system, yung computer, yung CPU, nag-create siya ng process para dun sa ating program, and yung process na yun yung nakikipag-communicate dun sa runtime environment, no? So it takes some care of memory allocation and the allocation while the program is being executed, no? So yung runtime environment yung nag-aayos na, no? Now we have what we call activation tree, no? A program is a sequence of instructions combining to a number of procedures. Instructions na procedure executed sequentially. So, hindi tayong, yung program natin, hindi pwedeng tumakbo starting from the bottom, no? So, laging nag-start siya sa entry point, no? And then from that, i-execute niya whatever na procedure na tawagin, no? Dun sa unang line ng ating command, no? The execution of procedure is called its activation, no? So, yung code natin are grouped into procedure. And once na i-call natin ng procedure, that is called the activation. The activation record contains all the necessary information required to call a procedure, no? So ito yung laman ng activation record. Temporaries stores the variables, values, and expression. Logical data stores the call procedure or the local data. Machine status, okay, kung ano yung mga kailangan niyang registers, program counter na gagamitin if, no? Yeah, may tawagin procedure. Then control link stores the address of activation record of the called procedure. Okay. Access link stores the information data which is outside the local scope, ibig sabihin naka-global. Actual parameters stores actual parameters which are used to send input to the called procedure. And return value stores return values. Yan ang laman ng activation record. Whenever a procedure is executed, its activation record is stored in the stack, also known as control stack. When a procedure calls another procedure, the execution of call is suspended until the call procedure is finished or finishes execution. So kapag may tinawag na procedure, ang isang procedure, ipapasa niya yung control dun sa tinawag na procedure, no? And then after na mat-finish ng call procedure ang kanyang execution, then it will return or transfer the control to the calling procedure. Okay? So, normally, yung processor gumagawa yun ng tinatawag na activation tree, no? So, for example, meron tayong code nito, no? Maraming method, no? So, printf method, scanf method, meron show data method, then printf function, method, also show data, and again printf. So kapag tinignan natin sa ginawa natin ng activation tree yan, we will have very much like this. Okay, so ito yung unang called procedure or method or function, and then after that it will pass the control to the second procedure, and then after that it will go to the next, to the next, and then return control to the next procedure, no? So we understand that procedures are executed in depth first manner. So pag sinabing depth first manner, dito siya nagsisimula sa root, no? So may tatlo kasing types ng depth first ano na manner, no? Yung pre-order, in order, and yung post order, no? Thus state stack allocation is the best suitable form of storage for procedure activation, kasi ang stack allocation is first in, first out, no? Kung sino yung nasa ibabaw, yun ang kanyang unang execute or kukunin, no? Storage allocation, runtime environments manages runtime memory requirements for the following entities, no? So bago i-run ng isang computer ang isang application or program, dinedetermine niya yung memory requirements noon, no? So kailangan niya malaman itong mga basic parts ng nung ating program, no? First yung code, no? It is known as the text part of program that does not change at runtime. Its memory requirements are known at the compile time, no? So pag kinumpile yung mga code mo, gaano kalaking memory yung kakainin niya or magagamit. Procedures, their text part is static. Ibig sabihin ng text part, yung kanyang name ay hindi nababago, no? Once mag-declare tayo ng procedure, hindi na pwede, naka-fix na yun, no? Hindi na siya pwedeng baguhin. But they are called in a random manner. That is why stack storage is used to manage procedure calls and activations. Variables are known at the runtime only unless they are global or constant. Pag sinabing global, hindi siya local, yung kanyang values or yung kanyang use ay pwedeng gamitin lahat ng procedure, no? Na nasa loob ng program. Pag constant naman, hindi siya ay ano, no? Fixed, no? Static, no? So heap memory allocation scheme is used for dynamic allocation and allocation memory for variables in runtime. So, kasi ang heap memory merong ang kanyang access ay random, which is dynamic. Okay? So ano yung stack allocation natin? Procedure calls and the activations are managed by means of stack memory allocation, no? It works in last in first out method, and this allocation strategy is very useful for recursive procedure calls. So pag sinabing recursive, yung repeatedly called na procedure, no? Safe allocation naman, variables local to a procedure allocated and deallocated only at runtime, no? If allocation is used to dynamically allocate memory to the variables and claim it back when the variables are no more required, no? So pag sinabing allocate, i-reserve. Yung deallocate, i-unreserve, no? So halimbawa, may gagamitin siyang variable, so magre-reserve siya ng memory. Pero pag natapos na yung execution ng variables, nagamit na siya, tapos na yung kanyang function, then yung memory niya, i-free na niya, no? I-deallocate dun sa variable na yun. Except statistically or statically allocated memory area, but stuck in heap memory can grow and sync dynamically and unexpectedly. Therefore, they cannot be provided with a fixed amount of memory in the system. So, hindi siya binibigyan ng fixed, no? Unlimited yung kanyang allocation. Ayan. Yung text memory, static data, ang pinaglalagyan niya fixed, no? Naka-fix na. But the stack memory, the heap memory, they have unlimited amount of allocation. Parameter passing, no? The communication medium among procedures known as parameter passing. So maraming procedure, di ba, ang ating program, ang ating code. So kapag may tumatakbong procedure at may kasabay na isa pa, no? Or I mean merong kasunod na tatakbong, may kasunod siyang tinawag na procedure, kung meron siyang ipapas na parameter or values, then that is called the parameter passing. Now, the variables from a calling procedure are transferred to the call procedure by some mechanism. So there are types of values that are passed, no? Number one is R value. Yan ito. Ang ibig sabihin ng R ay write. So, the value of the expression is called, the value of an expression is called its write value. The value contained in a single variable so becomes an R value if it appears on the right-hand side of the assigned operator. Ito tuloy nito, day equals 1. Okay? Yung right side niya, yun ang R value. L value, the location of memory address for an expression is stored, is known as the L value of that expression. For example, nag-declare tayo ng variable day, ginawa natin siyang 1. Yung day na yun, yun yung L value. Sa atin, day siya, but sa computer, siya ay memory address. Okay? Formal parameters, variables that take the information passed by the caller procedure are called formal parameters. Variables that take information, okay, pass by. So, ibig sabihin, yung pumapasok na information na binigay ng caller sa isang procedure, it is called formal parameters. Pag, ibig sabihin, ako yung procedure, may nagbigay sa akin ng, may tumawag sa akin and may nagpasa ng values, yung variable na nasa loob ko na magtatanggap or receive nung values na yon, they are called formal parameters. Yung actual parameters ng variables whose values or addresses are being passed to the call procedure are called actual parameters. Yung mga values naman na ipapasa nung tumawag na procedure, they are called actual parameters. Okay? So yung pinapasa na values, yun yung actual parameters. Yung tumatanggap, yun yung formal parameters. Okay? So, for example, meron tayong function 1. Ito, function 1. At ang laman ni function 1 is, ito, integer actual parameter equals 10. Call, so ito yung caller, fun 2 function. Ito yung fun 2, yung function number 2 natin, second function. At meron siyang formal parameter. Siya yung magre-receive nung laman ni actual parameter, yung pinasa. Okay? At ipiprint niya yun. Yan, formal parameters. Print formal parameters kung ano man yung laman ni actual parameter dito. Okay? Fast by value. Okay? So, formal parameters hold the information of the actual parameter depending upon the parameter passing technique used. So, it may be a value or an address. Pag sinabing address, edi yun yung L value. Pag sinabing value, din yun yung R value. So, doon muna tayo sa R value, pass-by value. In pass-by value mechanism, the calling procedure passes the R value of actual parameters and the compiler puts that into the call procedure's activation record. Okay? So, pag sinabing pass-by value, yung R value ang pinapasa ng procedure. Okay? Pass-by reference, yung L value ang pinapasa. In pass-by reference mechanism, the L value of the actual parameter is copied to the activation record of the call procedure, yung address, no? Yung left side ng ating expression. Yung R value, pass-by value, yun yung right side ng ating expression, yun ang pinapasa niya. Pag sinabi namang pass-by copy restore, this parameter passing mechanism works similar to the pass-by reference except that the changes to actual parameters are made when the call procedure ends, no? So, yung actual parameters na pinasa natin ay binabago niya. That is the copy, restore, pass, no? So, ito yung example niya. Yan. Okay? So, nag-declare tayo ng variable y, tapos meron tayong calling procedure. Ito yung calling procedure, ito yung called procedure, no? Ito yung method natin. Okay, so yung value natin, initialize natin, y equals 10. And then, yan, pinasa natin, di ba? The L value, yung left value, so this is called pass by reference, di ba? Pinasa natin dito sa procedure na to. Yan. Pero yung procedure, nung dineclare natin, iba yung kanyang pangalan, no? Siya ay formal parameter. So siya yung tumanggap ng value ni y. So, integer x, tinanggap niya yung value ni y, and then, pinasa niya dito, prenases, at ito yung result, naging 99 si x, no? Tapos, binago natin si actual parameters or yung L value reference na y, no? Ginawa natin 0. Okay? But, dito, paglabas niya rito sa actual, yung calling procedure, nung print natin si y, hindi siya 0. nag-print siya ay 99, which is the value of the formal parameters na 99. Okay? So, yun yung pass by copy restore. Okay? So, kinopy yung value ni x kay y, and then pinasa, and then restore ito sa 0. Okay? Pass by name. In pass by name mechanism, the name of the procedure being called is replaced by its actual body. Pag sinabing actual body, yun yung argument expressions. No? Katulad nito, ang sinasabing argument expression dyan yung y, o kaya ito yung x. No? So, ito daw, hindi niya ginagamit yung pag-call ng procedure, hindi yung pangalan ng procedure. Ang ginagamit niya mismo, yung argument. No? Yung, for example, yung x or yung y. Yan. The procedure called for the corresponding parameters in the body of the procedure so that it can now work on the actual parameters. No? But the same like the pass-by reference. Okay? So that's it for our compiler, and this is the end of our pre-final lesson 2. Okay?